The FX television series Shogun captivated audiences with its portrayal of a fictional Englishman shipwrecked in feudal Japan and his rise to power within a daimyo's feudal lord court. However, the real story of first contact between Japan and the West in the 16th century is no less dramatic, filled with cultural clashes, unexpected alliances, and a profound impact on Japanese history. Before Black Ships, the arrival of the Portuguese. Contrary to Shogun, the first Europeans to set foot in Japan were not English, but Portuguese. In 1543, a chance encounter led Portuguese sailors to the southern shores of Japan, marking the beginning of a complex relationship. Unlike the fictional portrayal in Shogun, the Portuguese initially came as traders, not conquerors. They introduced firearms, previously unknown in Japan, which quickly revolutionized samurai warfare. A fascination with the Nanban Southern Barbarians. The arrival of the Portuguese, nicknamed Nanban Southern Barbarians by the Japanese, sparked a period of curiosity and cultural exchange. Luxury goods like silk and glassware were traded, while Christian missionaries attempted to spread their faith, finding some success among certain daimyo. However, tensions arose due to the slave trade practiced by some Portuguese and the perceived threat posed by the growing influence of Christianity. The rise and fall of Christian influence. The early success of Christian missionaries, particularly among powerful daimyo, is a historical fact often overlooked in Shogun. Several daimyo converted to Christianity, seeing it as a potential source of power and prestige. However, this worried the established Buddhist clergy, who saw their influence waning. The arrival of Spanish missionaries further complicated matters, as their rivalry with the Portuguese created friction within the Christian community. A shift in policy, from tolerance to isolation. A legacy beyond Shogun. The real story of Japan's first contact with the West is a fascinating tale of cultural exchange, religious tensions, and a shift towards isolationism. While Shogun takes creative liberties, the historical core of the narrative serves as a springboard for understanding a pivotal moment in Japanese history. The arrival of the West not only introduced new technologies and ideas, but also set the stage for Japan's inward turn, which would shape the country for centuries to come.